Would you like to learn the 5 missing things for cloud architects on the AWS Solutions Architect Professional, the Azure Solutions Architect Expert, and the Google Professional Cloud Architect Exam? If so, this video is for you. My name's Mike Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers, and I've held every type of architecture role you could imagine for the last 25 years, and I've loved every last one of them. I've also spent more than 2 decades helping people like you get their first tech job, get promoted in tech, and I have architects that I've trained working at Apple, at Amazon, and Cisco, and IBM, and Microsoft, and Google, and Accenture, Deloitte, KPMG, Capgemini, PricewaterhouseCoopers, Barclays Bank, JPMorgan Chase Bank, and a whole host of other organizations throughout the entire world. And I want you to get a great architect job. And part of that is knowing the gaps between your certification and what we actually do in the architect world. So the first thing that's actually missing for architects out of the 5 things we're going to cover from these architecture certifications, it's actually the practice of architecture. So that sounds counterintuitive. How would you have an exam called the AWS Solutions Architect Professional or the Google Professional Cloud Architect without any architecture? Well, let's talk about what is taught in these programs. You were taught the name that the vendor called their services. For example, instead of a virtual machine, AWS calls it Elastic Compute Cloud. Google calls it a compute engine instance. Azure thankfully calls it an Azure virtual machine, so you know what it is. They teach you that name, and then they teach you how to turn it on. Now, that's great if you're a cloud admin and that's your role, but for an architect, we don't touch the technology. Here's what we do. We start out by working with our clients' executives to find the vision and the goals for their business. Where do they want that business to be now? 3 months from now, 6 months from now, 5 years from now, and 20 years from now, because we need to know that to design our systems. The next thing we do as architects look at how that organization operates. How does that client organization run? What are the business processes? What is the org chart? For example, how does sales occur? How is a product, if there's a product created, how is that product service? What does the supply chain look like? And we need to understand that, because if we're going to add technology and we add it incorrectly, it will destroy the business. So we have to learn how that business operates. We then need to understand and work with that client to re-architect the business processes or how they do things to make sure they're maximally effective for the business. And then after we know the ultimate goals, we can then work backwards to create a strategy to get that organization to their needs. And to create that strategy, we architects have to do the following. We have to bring in a team of people, typically engineers, to baseline our clients' systems. We need to look at their technology. What's their data center look like? What are their cloud systems look like? What's their network look like? What are their applications look like? What are their security systems look like? What are their voice and video systems look like? And we need to say, wow, will these current technology systems work for the future business goals? And if the answer is not, now it's time to actually create a new architecture. What does that mean? It means we've got an architect that then needs to lead a team of technology professionals to design the new architecture. Typically a team of about 15 to 50 people for 6 to 12 months to create this architecture. Now, after we create this architecture, we have to bring it back to the client, present it to key stakeholders, get their feedback, re-architect things based upon their feedback. And then at that point, we need to assess the organization's readiness for change. Do the people they have the sophistication to be able to work with this new architecture that we've created? If not, do they need to hire new people? Can they cross-train the people they have? And then when we get past that, we have to help our clients set up a governance structure for the implementation. And then we have to create a change management system. Every time they want to make a change in the system, what needs to occur? And that's the architecture piece, which we do. And that's why I say these cloud professional cloud architect, Azure Solutions Architect Expert, and AWS Solutions Architect Professional exams lack architecture. So that's the first thing that we covered. But there's 4 other critical skills that architects must have, which are not covered in these certifications. So let's talk about them. The next critical skill that's missing from these certifications is business acumen. If cloud architects and enterprise architects and AI architects and network architects are designing systems to improve our clients' business performance, and we don't understand business, well, how do we optimize someone's business performance? So that means the architect needs to understand business. They need to understand things like cost of capital and balance sheets and financial statements and business processes and business process re-engineering and those types of things. We need to be able to create business cases for the technology we do. We need to show how the technology is going to affect our clients in a positive manner. And we can't do that if we don't have business acumen. So business acumen skills are needed. The next set of skills that are completely missing from these certification exams are presentation skills. I'm going to tell you, in any architecture role, like a cloud architect or an enterprise architect role or an AI architect role, we're going to be giving presentations constantly. Presentations at conferences, presentations to key stakeholders at our clients, presentations to internal teams, presentations all the time. So if we, presentation skills are missing. So if your focus is on certification, please get the architecture skills, business acumen skills, and presentation skills. It'll help you have a much better architect career, or it'll help you have an architecture career. Now we'll talk about the last two things. The next one is sales skills. Most architects work in a customer-facing role. And even if we don't work in a customer-facing role, we work for the end client, we're still going to have to sell our architectures to the leadership for them to be adopted. Otherwise, they're just PowerPoint documents or RFPs that we responded to. So a good cloud architect, a good solutions architect, a good enterprise architect has the ability to sell the client on the solution, show that client how the solution will improve their business performance, and show that client why they need it, and be able to influence executives at the key client site to make the decision to move forward on the architecture. The last critical missing skill that we're going to discuss in this video for cloud architects that are missing from the AWS Solution Architect exam and the Google Professional Cloud Architect exam and the Azure Solutions Architect Expert exam is leadership. Now, here's the thing. No architecture is ever made by one person. It's going to take a team of architects and engineers for the properly designed. The cloud architect may be the leader. They may have some network architects working with them, security architects working with them, some AI architects working with them, some IAM architects working with them, some DevOps architects working with them, some application architects working on their team. And of course, we're also going to go to the engineers to get that nitty-gritty detail because that's their focus. So we may have some cloud engineers, some DevOps engineers, some software developers, some network engineers on our team. And we have to lead that team from the time we actually interact with that client until the client is effectively done. So we must have strong leadership skills. And these are the key things that we're missing. They are architecture, business acumen, presentation skills, sales skills, and leadership skills. So get these skills and you'll have a wonderful architecture career. Of course, we teach all these skills to any architects that we train. But if you're not with us, make sure you get these skills from somewhere because it's going to massively enhance your architecture career. If you'd like to become an architect, like a cloud architect or an enterprise architect or a security architect or an AI architect, we've got a lot of free resources for you and free webinars in the description of this video. Sign up for a free webinar or a free ebook, and we'll go over the role. We'll talk about what we do, and you can even ask us questions on any of our live webinars on Zoom. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you soon.